Okay, Michael, you got an answer for me?
Yeah, I think so. I kind of like the method of dropping features that we don't need. So I'm going to
Okay.
see if I can apply that idea. So for the decision tree case, if I had all four features, could I even learn this thing? I think I could. Let's see, I can do A, and if A is true, then I can split on B, and if B is true, then I output a plus. Otherwise, I output minuses.
So, is that a function? Do you know what function that is?
It's a decision tree.
Yes, but what do you know? There's a Boolean function that decision tree represents.
I don't know. Do you want to draw it and I can look at it?
Yeah, sure. Let's do that. So, first you split on A, and you said A is either 0 or 1. And then, in the case where it was a 1, you split on B. And if that were a 0, you output no. And if that is a 1, you output yes. And over here, you output no. That's what you said, right?
And that works for this example, or this set of examples. And let's see. So with one plus, oh, I see. So it's and, right? So it's if A and B are true, then the output's true, otherwise not.
Right. And in fact, that is exactly the function that I was thinking of. So
Ooh.
this the true underlying function here is in fact and of A and B.
All right. And oh, I see. So in particular, now we've answered the first question because. I need, well, okay, I only need A and B, and in fact, having just one of them alone isn't going to be enough. If I just had A, then the decision tree can't learn it, and if I just had B, then the decision tree can't learn it. It needs more information.
Right, and even with these examples, you can't really luck up and have pick C or D to learn this because C is always one, and so you can't output the correct answer for all cases. And D is one in the wrong place and zero in the wrong place, but zero in the right place a couple of times. So you can't do something like take the not of D and haven't gotten lucky.
I see. Well, yeah, and C in particular seems exceptionally useless.
Ooh, I like that word. I'm going to say useless. Useless. Okay, fine. So that's right. So it and maybe this helps you a little bit with the next one. I know that you now know what the true function is. It's AND A or B, and you decided that D doesn't help a lot and C is completely useless. Why'd you say it was useless, by the way?
Because it's the same in all the cases. It doesn't discriminate between the positive and the negative labels.
That's right. So it is useless in that regard. So good. This is the answer I was looking for decision trees. What about for the simple perceptron?
Okay, all right. So I'm not great at doing this kind of thing in my head, but I guess the good news is, oh, how about this? How about this? Since we got it down to only these two features matter, we can draw it as two-dimensional plane, right?
Okay.
So mark 0, 0, put a minus at 0, 0,
Okay.
put a minus at 0, 1, put a minus at 1, 0, and put a plus at 1, 1. So that's when we're using the A and the B features. And this
Yep.
is great because it's linearly separable. So we just need, yeah, we just need a set of weights that can do that. And let's see. So how do we do that? So if we add, let's see, if we do a weight of 1 on A and a weight of 1 on B,
Here, let
then.
me draw it and maybe that'll help. So you want to pick a weight vector, which is you said one for A and one for B. Okay. All right, go.
And that will give us for the first example, that gives us an output of 0. For the next one,
Okay.
an output of 1. The next one, an output of 1. And the last one, an output of 2. So we would like, if it was like, uh-oh, wait. So if the weight vector was that, then what we really want it to be is WTX greater than 1. But we can't. It says 0 there. In fact, wait, isn't it the case that if you don't have. If it's greater than or equals 0, it's really we're really talking about lines that go through the origin.
Yep, that's right. This is an origin-limited perceptron.
So it seems like we're hosed, right? Where there isn't going to be a separator that goes to the origin that lops off the plus.
That's right.
So I guess what we usually do in perceptrons is we include was it like a bias unit, like a something that's all ones. And then that lets us move the threshold around.
Right. So normally this would look like this. W transpose X plus B is greater than 0. But I didn't let you have that, so you can't have that.
Ah, but maybe I can. You say I can add B in. What if I could add C in? Because if you look at this, well, look at the C column. It's all ones. It's the same as if it was like the thing that you called B a moment ago, this bias unit. So if we actually include A, B, and C as our features, then we can represent this with a, what did you call it, origin limited perceptron.
Right. So then, and I'll even draw it in a different color. If we had W, B, would you have 1, 1, and?
I'm going to say negative 1.
Negative 1. And that's A, B, and C. Then what would that give you in the first case?
So negative 1, 0, 0, 1.
Yep.
So it's only the positive example is the only one that's greater than 0, strictly greater than 0.
Yep, that's exactly right. So you still think C is useless?
I see. Well, when I said useless, I meant it didn't give any information.
But and that's exactly right. It doesn't give any information, but that does not make it useless.
Interesting. Okay, well, I now regret that word choice.
C's everywhere across the world are thanking you. So this actually brings me to the last point that I want to make about feature selection, which really gets down to noticing the difference between useless and what I'm going to call relevant. So let's dive into that, okay?
Yeah, that would be really helpful. Is that, and that's the right answer, the first three?
Yes, that's the right answer.
Cool.